Welcome to the Park Cultural Landscapes Program training video on compressed air-powered excavation, also known as air-spading. In this video, we will demonstrate techniques for relieving soil compaction and therefore improving soil conditions around historic trees. The purpose of preservation horticulture in the National Park System is to retain the historic character of vegetation and to extend its longevity. Soil aeration is one of many interventions used by resource managers to preserve historic trees in national park cultural landscapes. By learning about this technique, you'll be able to contribute to the preservation of cultural landscapes in your park. Soil compaction around historic trees is a common problem in NPS cultural landscapes and is caused mainly by foot traffic, vehicles, construction activity, heavy rainfall, and some kinds of irrigation. Compaction of soil within the root zone impacts the health of plants by reducing space for air, water, and nutrients within the soil, which shortens the lifespan of woody plants. Trees and shrubs in compacted soil are often starved of air, water, and nutrients. As a result, they have dead wood in the canopy and a lack of new growth. Air spading is a form of excavation that has several applications for improving soil conditions and plant health, including root collar excavation, where excessive soil is removed from the base of a tree trunk, radial trenching, and vertical mulching. Radial trenching is used to extensively augment soil composition, improve aeration and drainage, and encourage root growth to depths of 10 to 12 inches. To accomplish this, shallow trenches are excavated in a radial pattern around the trunk. Vertical mulching is a more targeted application used where more extensive radial excavation of the root zone is impractical. Both applications are used to break up the soil, add fresh soil and nutrients, and invigorate the plant's root system. Airspading uses a fiberglass barrel connected to a hose to deliver compressed air into the soil within the tree drip line. The air travels through the nozzle at speeds in excess of 1,200 miles per hour. The air loosens the soil structure but doesn't sever tree roots. This relieves compaction and allows for nutrient-depleted topsoil to be removed or blended with new topsoil and amendments. Other applications of air spading include non-destructive excavation of archaeological resources located within a plant's root system. In this example at Morristown National Historical Park, cultural resource managers used air spading to gently remove artifacts attached to the root ball of an uprooted tree. In preparation for an air spading project, consider the following. Before beginning your project, consult with natural resource, cultural resource, and facility specialists regarding the presence of wildlife, artifacts, and underground utilities. While air spading is considered a non-destructive method of excavation in most situations, care must be taken to avoid unintended impacts. Air spading requires specialized skills and equipment. Only trained horticulture professionals that have experience with commercial compressors should operate an air spade. Park managers can procure this work through a micro purchase by credit card for jobs under $10,000 or a service contract. Air spading often involves a collaborative, team-based approach. For this historic tree at John Muir National Historic Site, park staff and local volunteers, including certified arborists, worked over the course of 2 days to aerate the compacted soil, assess the root system, deeply irrigate the soil, and add new compost. When operating or working near an airspade, remember to always wear the appropriate clothing and PPE to protect eyes, hands, feet, and ears. In dusty conditions, an improved respirator may be necessary. Air spading is best performed during the dormant season when temperatures are above freezing and when the soil is not waterlogged or excessively dry. For radial trenching, a vegetable-based spray paint may be used to mark a radial pattern emanating from the tree trunk like spokes of a wheel. The trenches are marked from the trunk flare to the drip line of the canopy, located 1.5 feet apart around the trunk flare. Before trenching begins, plywood sheets are leaned against the trunk to protect the bark from blasted soil. The air spade is used to create shallow trenches in a radial pattern. Trenches are excavated from the edge of the drip line toward the root collar, roughly 4 inches wide and 8 to 12 inches deep. The AirSpade operator holds the barrel at a 30 to 45 degree angle to excavate the trench at the appropriate depth, while wanding from side to side to excavate the trench width. Though not shown here, plywood sheets can be laid on either side to cover adjacent trenches to prevent them from refilling with the freshly excavated soil. Soil that's deposited on the plywood sheets by the AirSpade can be collected and amended before backfilling. With the roots exposed, the arborist can assess their condition and determine if additional treatments are necessary. For aeration in high foot traffic areas, the trenches may be partially filled with sand or pea gravel before adding topsoil. To improve fertility, compost and organic nutrient amendments are combined with topsoil for the backfill. The tool can also be used to punch vertical holes into the soil within the root zone, enabling new soil and nutrients to be added. Called vertical mulching, this technique creates boreholes 18 to 24 inches deep between tree roots. The holes are then filled with fresh material. The process is complete when the whole area within the drip line of the canopy has been treated, plywood is removed, all trenches have been backfilled, and the area within the drip line is thoroughly irrigated. Soil condition is just one of the many important metrics that directly contribute to plant health. Aerating and amending compacted soil using an AirSpade is one way to prolong the life of historic trees and contribute to the preservation of cultural landscapes in your park. Please consult the following resources for more information on AirSpading applications and how to procure professional arborist services through GSA Advantage.